almost everyone knows what it feels like to try, and sometimes fail, to acquire better habits. According to Aristotle, such character improvement is an essential part of living a good life. So if we're serious about becoming better people, it's crucial that we figure out how to become more virtuous. Luckily, there's quite a bit of scientific and philosophical research that can help us in this quest. First, it's important to notice the relationship between character, virtues, habits, and actions. A good character is made up of all the essential virtues, like courage, compassion, honesty, and so on. Each of these virtues is made up in turn by habits. A courageous person, for instance, is someone who regularly does things that make her uncomfortable, and who isn't afraid to risk physical safety for a worthy goal. Finally, each of these habits is formed through action. The more courageous actions I perform, the easier it becomes to perform them, and the more courageous I consequently become. Recent findings in social science tell us that it's not enough to just desire to acquire some habit and then force ourselves to behave accordingly, and that much of our action is influenced by physical and social factors that are beyond anything over which we have direct control. Recent findings in the science of the brain also tell us that habit acquisition often functions as a kind of loop. When we encounter a cue, like the feeling of a hangnail, for instance, we start to crave routine behavior, like biting our nails, which produces a reward in our brains, here a kind of neurological relief. Habits can be morally good or bad, extremely useful or self-destructive. So if we want to follow Aristotle, we'll have to narrow in and define a particular virtue that we'd like to cultivate. Then, we'll have to break this virtue down into the habits and actions that make it up. Along the way, we'll want to define cues and rewards for ourselves and track our progress over time. In today's activity, you'll be prompted to do just that.